Hi everybody. Happy Wednesday. My name's Maria. Welcome to my channel. So I put a video up this past weekend, showing the flower garden of the Tree of Life Afghan, which is really called Trees Breeze. And it's an original design by Nicky Epstein, who's just a fantastic designer. And the pattern came from her book, Cover Up with Nicky Epstein, from her personal knitted Afghan collection, which I have right here. This is her book. And I got it at the library for $5. Not bad. I have several of her books, but I couldn't find this one. So I'm glad that I did. And in her book here is Trees Breeze. Now, Lion Brand and Ravelry and many other places. I also have my recipes in this book. I gotta stop doing that. Stuffing the book with everything. There's so many beautiful things in her book. But one of her most popular, all of them are beautiful. But one of her most popular ones is called Trees Breeze. Okay, and here it is right here. Now, Nikki writes up her pattern just a little different. This is the large. And you can see you've got four twin trees. And then a little divider section I call the fences. And some little flower buds. See? Pretty flower buds. And then divider again. And then four twin trees again. Divider. And then flower buds. And then trees. And then you bind off. And then you sew the tulip border in. So there's one, two, three, four different parts of this pattern, but then there's the beginning setup. So it's a multiple of 44 plus 4. So when you begin, you're going to cast on 44 plus 4 for how many trees you want. So there is a baby blankie miniature version, heirloom blanket, which is really precious, made with Pound of Love antique yarn that I've made five of now, that Lion Brand has out. I'll list the pattern again. And then there's this one, and Lion Brand has put this one out too. And if you can't get the book, the pattern number is this chart too, if you like charts better. What's with all the recipes I got going on in here? Yellow cake, macaroni and cheese. Okay. Tree of Life Afghan by Lion Brand. Okay. Pattern number 70122AD. So this one here is, you have to remember to read the beginning of the Afghan. And it will tell you to cast on 180 stitches. For the large, for the baby blanket, you'll cast on 92. You will stay with that cast on, but within that cast on are in the two setup rows here, are knitting four on the side or purling four in row two, depending on which side you're on, the right side or the wrong side. And so you're going to be carrying four stitches at the beginning, like you'll do four stitches, and then you'll do whatever it tells you, and then you'll do your repeat, and then before you get to the next one, you'll do four stitches, so four and four is eight, and then you'll do your repeat, and then you'll do, before you do the next one, you'll do four stitches, so 12, and then 16 stitches, and then at the end, you'll do 20. So it's four before each. 4 times 4, and then at the end. So you begin, you begin, you begin, you begin, and then at the end. So I think you're carrying 16 stitches for the baby blanket that's right in the cast-on. And when you get to the divider, you'll continue to keep those stitches the same count. Your trees will go up, and you'll be using M1s, make ones, to increase. And when they grow up and out, then you'll be going right back down to 180 for the large and 92 for the small. Once you get past the divider, it's really important to pay attention to knitting or purling the extra row it tells you to, and whether you begin on the wrong side or the right side. So you begin the afghan on the wrong side. Well, first you begin by stockinette, knitting a row and purling a row, which gives it a curl all the way around. So you will be dealing with that curl. So I would suggest doing a cast on that facilitates sewing into the border nice, like maybe a crochet cast on or a knitwise cast on. I wouldn't suggest a double stranded or I guess what I would stay away from is a long tail cast on, because it will already be curling and you're going to be sewing your border in. And so it just adds extra material when you do a long tail, because you're actually got an extra row of knitting there, like a little ledge. So I would do a finer one, like maybe a crochet cast on. And you're just going to stay at your stitch count, but when you get to the flower part, 12, it's 12 plus 1. So you're at, say, 180 here. When you get to here, and you're at 180 for the divider, when you get to here, you're going to increase in your first stitch by making another stitch. So if you wanted to work this up plain, you would simply add 1 to 12. So I've got 25 stitches here. And in case folks didn't know, I uploaded my video and then I mistakenly deleted it on my phone app on YouTube. I thought, it's kind of crazy. Which is how things go. I really thought I was deleting videos I had that synced into my phone. My phone was saying I needed storage, so I started deleting. And this one I couldn't recover, the knitting one. So to anyone that's asking, do I have permission, formal permission, to do the flower garden? No. Neither does anyone else. It's just part of the pattern. And it's already uploaded on Lion Brand by Lion Brand Notebook in pictorial pictures and video. And if you look under the baby blanket for Tree of Life Afghan, a lot of people are getting confused at the area of the flower garden. So I just thought I would show. There's other videos out where nobody's talking. They just got music playing and they're doing the whole flower garden. If you want the tulip border, I don't have permission to do that, but I am taking my P's and Q's from a lot of people at Ravelry and all who have told me, as long as other people are uploading it, you've got a free pattern, you've got the book, you can do parts of it. So there are women out here doing the pattern, the tulip border, and then sewing it in to show how that's done. And there's also people that are doing parts of the flower garden to show how to make the stems or how to make the leaves. They're just breaking it down. They're just calling it something else, like make a flower, make a leaf, make a stem. It's Nicky Epstein's, okay? Lion Brand is calling it Tree of Life when it's really Tree's Breeze. They're saying inspired by Nicky Epstein. So all is good. I can't show you the whole thing. I could just go over the pattern with you. But it's really simple. This is the part that people are getting confused at, so I'll go as quick as I can. You're going to have a little bit of knit, purl, knit, purl, knit, purl, stockinette going on before you get to beginning your 12-row repeat for your flower. And so that's what I've got here. I've knitted and purled 4 rows, knit, purl, knit, purl, knit, purl, and then I purled another row. Okay, so row 1, and from row 1 to row 6, you're just going to do the opposite. So I'm not going to stay on the camera the whole time to keep this short. So we're going to knit, or purl, I'm sorry, 12. So I have 25 stitches on here. Six, seven, and I'm using purple mainstay grape economy yarn. From the Church of Walmart. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That was splitty. 9. Ten, 11, 12. Okay, so you're either going to be purling or knitting your 12. If you're working this within the actual pattern, it's going to tell you to purl 10 in the beginning because you're making the first two stitches in that first stitch, so you'll only have to do 10. When you get to your 13th stitch of the first row, you're going to knit into the back. So K1B, knit into the back loop. K1BL, like knit into the back loop, just like that. Okay, and that is the beginning of your stem of your flower. Then you're going to purl 11 and purl one at the end. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 3, 4, 5, 6, and that's 11, and then you purl the last one. Do this. I purl differently than some people because I continental Mediterranean purl. I'm trying to keep my hands in the camera. So row two, you are just knitting what you see. So if you see a knit stitch, you pull down on it and there is a crisscross V, that's what you're doing. And this pattern has a lot of that, where on the opposite row, you're just knitting what you see. So you're knitting 12 again. You should be able to read your work. You'll be able to see a little bump here, a wrap, whereas the other ones are a crisscross, like that, like a V shape. But then you see a wrap here. That is your 13th stitch. So we're going to purl into the back now. We're going to follow what we see here for our stem, and we're going to P1B. So we're going to purl in the back. So we're going to bring our yarn to the front. Come in as if you were to purl, wrap around, and slip that off, okay? And then we're going to knit 11. I'm going to count that because I have an extra stitch because I had a split. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep. So I'm going to put two together right here. I had a split earlier. It's my scrap yarn. It's good yarn. It's mainstay. You can rip it out over and over again. It's going to be fine. But I get to scrappy parts of it. Okay. And so then three. You're going to purl your 12. You're just doing what you see. You're going to do this to row 6. So I'm going to go off camera. So this is 3. So we're just purling what we see. You could pretty much read your work and just do what you're doing. Just remember for the stem to go into that back loop and either knit or purl. So we're purling. So this should be a knit into the back loop, right? I'll show what I mean in a minute. I'll come up to it. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. This is a stitch that just got, it fell. So I'm going to pick it up and fix it. I hope. And now I'm in 12 right here. You can see there's no wrap there. So I'm going to knit into the back of it. Yeah. And then just purl the rest. Should be 11. I picked up an extra stitch along the way. That's 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and then just purl that last one. So now I'm on row 4. You can almost begin to see the little stems start to pop up. So you're just following what you're doing. I'm going to go ahead and do four through six. Which would be knitting. And then I'll come right back for row 7. So I'll be right back. So just knit and then purl. And do that back loop thing to your stem. I'll be right back. Okay, so now we're on row 7. And it should be looking like this. You should be able to see your stem standing up. I have a little smulch going on here. Which I'll take care of. I'll tidy it up in a minute. Let me do that right now. Which is why I keep bobby pins handy. This is just a little splitty stuff that I didn't get. And if you don't, you know, if you're working with yarn that splits, it will get in the way. Okay, so I'll pick that up and put it somewhere. But you can see the stem there, right? So for row 7, you're going to go ahead and purl 8. There's only 12 rows in this. So you're going to purl 8. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. All right. I keep remembering to pull my stitches up. So here's where we want to take a crochet hook and kind of just pinch these over so your needles are in the way. Or so your stitches out of your way of your needles. You're going to go to the right side, to the bottom first row right here with your crochet hook. I try to use a crochet hook that's even a little smaller, or it doesn't have to be matchy-matchy, but not too much bigger than the needle size you're using. So I'm using a 5.0. Let me just put it on the right needle like this. Elongate it as much as you can. Pull your loop up. So this is a 5.0 US 8 needle. So I'm using a 5.0 crochet hook. So you go ahead and you draw a loop up on the right side of the bottom of the stem. And then you knit the next, make it around that. All right. So you knit the next stitch, and then you're going to do what's called a PSSO, past slip stitch over. You're going to take that elongated one and slip it right over the stitch you knitted. And now, I'm knitting kind of tight today. You're going to purl the next three. One, two, three. You should be right up to your stem. You're going to knit into the back of your stem. K1B. Then purl three again. And then we're going to come to the other side of our stem right here, the bottom, row one, and bring that up. And just give yourself a lot of room, because if they get too tight, they just loosely, they will pucker. Knit the next stitch, and then PSSO, left needle, left to right, pass your slip stitch over the knitted stitch. And now you have a little stem here, and a leaf here and here. And now we're going to purl three. And you should have five stitches left to knit. I mean purl. I'm sorry. So one, two, three, four, five. So far, so good. Okay, so that was row seven. And when you get to row eight, you're just going to, I'm going to find it. I'm looking at it here. I always want to check this one. You're just going back to knitting your 12. Then we're going to play at row nine. So you're just going to knit your 12. Okay, and then you'll see you're up to your stem again, but you're going to P1B, you're going to purl in the back of it, because you can see it's got a little bump there, a wrap, so it's a purl. So purl into the back of it, and then you just go on knitting, and I'm going to bring this stitch, if you can find it, it's right here, smelchy bit. Where'd it go? Don't fail me now, eyes. It's right here. Even though this is a sample, those little splits can really hang you up and look funny. All right. So then you're just going to keep knitting. I'm going to try to get under that split. All right, so it'll be 11. One. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, 9, 10, 11, and you knit your last one. So, I might have dropped something there, but I doubt it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25. Let me count it again. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, 20, 22, 24, 25. I just think, and this is what I mean, sometimes if you pull too tight where your stem is, you can get a little, it'll fill in, but you can get a little bit of a space there you don't really want. So in row 9, what we do is we are going to make some fancy stitches. We're going to make 7 stitches out of 1. And this is, a lot of people were having trouble with how do you make the stems, then how do you make the leaves, then how do you make the flower bud, and it says you're going to make 7 stitches out of 1. It's in parentheses with an asterisk, and it says after the parentheses to do this 3 times. So what you're going to do first is purl. This is row 9. You know, purl 12, I think. I can't see with the camera on my head. 1, 2, 3. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12. And actually what we're doing is we're going to be working into the top of the stem. So you will be right up to your stem. I got a little too tight. When you're knitting, don't do like I do. Don't get too far down the point or your stitches will get way too tight. I always get a little nervous when I'm on camera and I start knitting tight. Okay, so we're actually going to knit into this stem we've been working out of doing all the front and back. Purl one in the back, knit one in the back. We're going to work into that stem, but we're not going to go in the back. We're going to go in the front and we're going to knit one and yarn over 3 times, and then we're going to knit one. So you're going to go in, knit one. Don't disconnect. Yarn over. So we yarn around the needle on the right. Go back in, knit. Don't disconnect. Yarn over. Go back in, knit one. Yarn over again, and then knit one. And it's sort of like a cluster stitch or a bumblebee stitch or whatever, popcorn stitch in crochet. You just got to kind of straighten them out because you're going to be purling them in the next row. So you can count. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? And then you're right back to purl 11. And this is 10, and this is 11. Let me just purl this one. And now for row 10, we're going to knit 12, then we're going to purl those 7 right there. So we're going to knit our 12. It's row 10, we only got 12 rows. I'm trying to loosen mine up by going in a little further before I yarn over and exit. I'm trying to give myself some space here. loosen up my stitches. You really got to remember to push your stitches over too if you're a tight knitter like me. Okay, so that should be 12, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. Okay, so now you just want to separate them a little bit and bring your yarn to the front and purl. And remember, I purl continental style Mediterranean, but if you purl American English, you're going to be wrapping around. And I would hold on to this stitch so it doesn't fall off while you're purling the 7. And there's the beginning of your little flower bud right there. And then we just knit 11 again. Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, and then we knit the last one. And for row 11, we're going to purl 12. So you're just doing the opposite. So it has a really sweet stockinette look going on. Right? So you're going to purl your 12. Very redundant, very simple. Okay, and we are up to our flower stem up here, okay? So now you want to really make sure you separate these out well. And if you have splitty yarn, just put it where it belongs. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so now we're going to knit into the back of 2. And this one is a split, I can see that. So we're going to knit into the back of these 2, looking for the rest of the smulch that's with it. The splitty stuff, I don't see it. And then we're going to knit into the back of 3 all together. And then we're going to knit into the back of 2. So now we should have 3 stitches for our flower bud. It's starting to take shape now. Okay, and then we purl our 11. Eight, nine, 10, 11, and then purl our last one. And then we are to row 12. And we turn. You can see our little flower there. We turn. And we knit 12. What's going on there? Splitty. I'm gonna name this video Splitty Yarn Video. Alright. So we knit 12. For row 12. So now we have 3 stitches here, and we're going to purl them as we normally would. So bring our yarn in the front and go underneath all 3 and purl them together. And there's a little flower bud. And then knit our 11. And that's 10, 11. So you can make dishcloths. You can put a border around this. As you're working them, if you start off with purling 10 or 12, you can kind of play with it. And this pattern particularly will tell you to do like a stockinette, right? You can pop it out this way too. It looks even better. I think, you know, this could be the right side. Looks better, I think. I think this is the right side, to tell you the truth. So we started with. Yeah, so let's see. 12 was an even number. That would be the right side. So, I mean, but you can see how if you pull too tight with that, it will make a pucker. As you're going, it won't do that. But if you turn it this way, yeah. Oh, this is the wrong side. I'm sorry. This is the right side. Okay. And you'll know by the stem. Obviously, I'm looking at it. I'm looking in the camera, so it's backwards. All right, so this is the right side. So there will be these little holes. Not bad. As you block it out, and even the little puckering, when you wash and block out the flower area, that will go away. And then you can just kind of shape your little leaves. But again, really elongate your stems. And then you'll just knit on top of this. And this will actually become more flat as you knit on top of this, and then your next flower will be here, and your next flower will be here in the following rows. So that is the flower garden area of Nicky Epstein's garden for her Trees Breathe, what Lion Brand is calling Tree of Life blanket. I wanted to remake the video because I started to have comments of people asking questions, and it is one that there's an entire notebook out there on Lion Brand, which really explains, and people just, they finally make it through the trees cabling, which the pattern is written beautifully. It's written so that you can really understand what you're doing. The stitch explanation is there. I will say the cabling that you're doing, whatever you have to cable with, the cabling that you're doing with the trees I'm using clover, Takumi clover cable, and I'm also using Takumi clover needle and mainstay yarn for the sample. People will get through all the trees and be like, okay, now what do I do? And so there's notebooks out there, there's pictorials, and there's partially uploaded videos, but I haven't seen one where you do the whole flower yet, so I wanted to show it. So there it is. There's your flower. And, I mean, you could do this, you could do a wall hanging, you could do your buds a different color. There's all kinds of things you can do with this and get creative. So it's just a really fun little pattern. All right, so that is, I'm going to re-upload it and not delete it this time. Okay, take care, everybody. I hope you'll try this. You'll just go on with row 1, 2, 3, 4, and you'll go on again to make more flowers. All right? Thanks for hanging with me. Bye-bye. Have a nice day.